before any spot. This is what I use for the color coding, so I know what strain is that. So, and I'll put this one here. Stair right here. And we'll stir it up well. Work on this one now. Alright, there should not be any kind of contamination. Are my pretty pieces, so I'm gonna inoculate this one with the liquid culture, so that once I have these pretty pieces with the mycelium, then I'm gonna start transferring them into different pretty pieces and also into liquid culture, and you can do the grain spawning too. So plant has a moisture buildup. So anything that has moisture, they try to avoid it and then keep it for now for different time. Some of them are still these four of these ones are good. So I'm gonna keep these ones out of way, put them back and let it dry. Paper towel. And soak it out. All right. So we do one by one. I would always try to avoid the interior part touching directly, and then twist this one out. Mm-hmm. it, and sometimes you gotta deal with it. If it breaks, it breaks, you know. But if you have a little bit longer, you should be able to work on it. These ones were my King Blue Oyster. little. And then I'm gonna put 3 jars in each put this one in an incubator, and I have 2 more strains to go. So Italian oyster and black pearl king is gonna go into the one bag, and then take care of these stuff. So let's take it. So let me turn the light on. Turn the light on and then start bringing the stuff here. So I have this to work on these ones. So these ones will stay here, and I have some more strains already inoculated. So those ones have been inoculated like a couple days ago, and then I have some more that needs to go back into the incubator. There's a black pearl king. So let me put this one up here. The second generation Italian oyster. So this one is also black for him. King blue oyster. There you go, guys. So as you guys can see the difference in color, it's the same thing, but once you have the mycelium start growing, so you will see a difference in color. So these ones are light, very light, and looking pretty good and clear. So we still need to wait for like at least a week to fully colonize. And then this one is just placed today. So we'll wait for these guys, all right? So I usually keep the temperature at about 70 to 75 Fahrenheit. So that's actually a room temperature. So I'll leave as is for now, and then if I need to make any adjustment I will, but I have not done anything so far, so everything looks good so far. All right, guys, so I need to take care of these like stuff and put it aside, and that's it for now. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and this is just the start, and I am working on my mycelium like liquid culture, grain spawn, and also many other things. So, and this lab has just been set up and it's not finished yet, but this is a sterile environment to work here, so that's why I'm working. But I hope you guys like my video. If you guys like my video, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, share, and also stay connected with me so that you guys know my journey into the world of mycology. Alright guys, you guys have a great day.